The foundation of Goodwill's mission is really about people, as you just heard here, regardless of circumstance, the background, the barriers they may face. And I'd like to introduce you now to a young lady who has been part of the Goodwill family, and it is a family, really, since 2010. Let's hear from Violet.
It is definitely an honor to be here, but if I could call your attention to the tables really quick. Have you looked at the little table holders, the little placeholders? Can somebody read what it says? Number 6, what does yours say? 14. 7.
Passion.
20. We could go on with all of these different words, and it seriously describes so many of us. And it describes me. I wasn't sure what I was going to come up here and say, since I'm quite an impromptu speaker, but let me just tell you a little bit about myself. I came here to Goodwill in 2010, hoping to get a job after being referred from Chrysalis Ministries. I had made a mistake in my life. I'd been homeless, and I was only accepted into 2 different halfway houses throughout Texas after being released from TDC. The Texas Department of Criminal Justice. I wasn't sure what my life would look like, much less 5 years later. In 2010, I was able to be hired by Goodwill, starting at a temp position at $7.25 an hour, being able to be accepted as part of the customer care team. By 2011, I was finally able to be reunited with my family. That bond had been extremely broken to the point where it was pretty much my problem, and I had to figure out how to get out of that. But we were able to at least meet and bond together again and make amends. By 2012, I was able to earn a promotion with Goodwill as a Good Choices Administrator. If you see in the little booklet, page 9, that's my baby. That's my baby with the Good Choices portal. It was extremely a learning experience, but also a progression for my career by the way that I was able to work from the beginning to the end on being able to know what those barriers are that individuals face when they're coming back into the workforce or that is keeping them out of the workforce. I've been there. My heart was completely in to where I can help them be able to overcome those by identifying resources, by identifying the community programs that are available. That year was basically my part of connections. And by 2013, I was also being able to work on my credit and being able to really work on that after having quite a history of bad credit and student loans in default since I'd been away for a while. Along with many other things, I was able to become a certified personal finance counselor for Goodwill and bought my house by 2013. I wish I would have been warned of the taxes and the other responsibilities. So by 2014, I set myself on another mission, being able to maintain my job and continue my education. I said, I need a part-time job. I want to buy this for the house. I want to do this to the house. And I wanted to do all these different things. And then plus, I got this little mail with taxes for this year that I had to pay. So I wish that I could say that everything is perfectly fine afterwards. But even by then, 22 interviews later, I was finally able to obtain a part-time job because of my background. 22 interviews later. All I wanted was to be a janitor or be a greeter at the door. I really wasn't asking for much, but that's how long it took, so quite an eye-opener. By 2015, more change. And I earned a promotion with a company that I work with now. It's called Tav Health, and it's a healthcare and IT industry. Somebody actually opened their arms and received me for the skills and experience that Goodwill allowed me to accomplish and gain. And I'm doing pretty much the same thing, connecting people with community resources. Here in San Antonio, I was helping people around the 22 surrounding counties. Today, I work with TAV Health as a community resources agent, and I help people across the nation. Has my life been changed? Yes. I'm now engaged. But this is what you do by being here today and continuing to support the mission of Goodwill and the local nonprofits. You're changing a lot of lives. And back to the table holders, if you're sitting at that table, that's what your purpose is here today, to make a difference and an impact, whether it's empowerment, whether it's table three,
training,
table four,
partnership,
and number one, number five,
service,
and number 18. Thank you.